Okay, for some reason we can't hear Lamar. Let me go to Nick in Tampa. Nick?
Yes, what I'd like to say is in the Christian faith, Jesus is recognized as God. He's not recognized. He's referenced as a prophet,
mm-hmm.
but he's recognized as God. When he spoke to Abraham, the Pharisees asked him, who you are. He said, I before Abraham, I am. And they said, well, you couldn't have been born. Well, born before he said that, they said, Abraham was born before you. And he said, before Abraham, I am.
Cool.
In other words, he pre-existed with the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Muslim faith wants to recognize him just as a prophet, but you don't recognize him as God. And that's a major thing, because he made it clear that I am the way, the life, the truth. No one comes to the Father except by me. And there's no name given under heaven that man can be saved by. I hate to say it, but you can try to say that, he's a prophet and we relate to him as a Muslim. But the truth about it is you don't recognize him as God.
You recognize
Allah.
That's...
And Allah, to me, and I'm not being facetious or anything, but your faith, Allah doesn't exist. And Muhammad was just was a man. He was married to a very wealthy woman that enabled him to establish the Muslim faith. The Muslim faith was established 700 years before Christ came. So
before,
it's a nice connection that you're making, but it's a false connection.
Nick,
I'd just like to make that point clear.
Nick,
true Christian faith recognizes Jesus.
Nick.
And Jesus said he was God.
Nick.
Okay.
Nick.
So that's a.
Hello.
That's something that. Yes, hello.
Yeah, just one correction. I think Muhammad came after Jesus, not before.
No, he came. He was in the 7th century. After. Correct.
Yeah,
correct.
And everything you said is correct in the sense that, yes,
well,
we as Muslims...
recognize him as God.
Yeah, that's true. Yes,
right.
That's 100% true.
And that it's a falsehood to say he's just a prophet.
But the same way, I would never say I should be killing you because you don't believe in what I believe.
I
think Jesus would prefer that you try rather than bad name, my God, is to try to bring me into your faith.
But not on this earth, but spiritually, if you don't receive Christ, in the next life, you're going to go to hell. I'm sorry, but that's the truth about it.
Yes, but
you don't recognize him as God.
I understand, Nick, very, very well.
Yeah.
Trust me.
Okay.
But how can you try to bring me to Jesus if you start the conversation with me by bad-mouthing Allah or Muhammad?
No, I'm not bad-mouthing. I'm just making a point because you want to make the point that, you recognize him as a prophet, but... See, but that's not good because he's not just a prophet. And I'm not bad-mouthing you at all.
No, when you say the bad negative things about Allah, when you say Allah is false.
Allah is in existence. There's no God that exists outside of Jesus.
Okay, Nick. Thank you so much.
Well,
I appreciate the effort. Thank you. Lamar, you're back.
I don't know about that. I do the snake in my pool, for real. And I have to go, so you committed snake-icide. So
oh, my God. Okay. Are you safe now?
I'm sorry?
Are you okay?
I'm okay.
Okay.
Thank you for asking.
You must be in Florida.
you're in Florida.
Exactly.
Not snakes on a plane, snakes in the pool.
Okay.
That's a movie reference. But anywho, the last caller, this isn't my job to convert people and whatnot, but it's entirely their beliefs. When I was talking to my pastor, we actually once had an interfaith dialogue with the Jewish temple down the road, and, pastor said, listen, is God so petty and small-minded to say, you got it this right and you got it this much right? I don't think God's like that. And they sang a little tune that said, what do Muslims dream of? When they take a little Muslim snoop, do they dream of jihad against Christians, or do they dream of jihad against the Jews, or both? And don't you wear that towel off your head, we're gonna get on you.
Okay. Lamar is our friend who keeps calling, who was a while ago. What was his name? Robert. Anyways, we went from one topic to the other. Let me go to Steven. Steven, you're in St. Pete. You have a minute.
Oh, I just make a few points here real quick. In Galatians chapter 1, the Apostle Paul was writing to the church, and he goes, if we are an angel, preach any other gospel unto you than the one that we had delivered to you before, let him be accursed. I say now, and I say it again. And it's the only time that he ever repeated the same words. Based on that, what Paul wrote, which is over 500 years before Islam and 2,000 years before Mormonism, any religion that teaches that new revelation came to them from an angel would contradict what Paul said there. So Paul made it clear.
So is Paul a prophet, Stephen?
What's that?
Paul, is Paul a prophet or was a companion of Jesus?
He was the apostle of the Gentiles.
But did he live the time of Jesus? He met Jesus?
Yeah, on the road to Damascus.
And then wrote a book in the Bible?
Well, he didn't write it. All the scripture, Paul said, the gospel that I received, I didn't learn it from men. I knew that was taught it by men, but by direct revelation from the Lord Jesus Christ. So Paul was the apostle of the Gentiles.
Okay, because I got confused. I didn't know Paul was also a prophet that can get revelation.
No, not really. I mean, no. He was the apostle of the Gentiles. So he was raised to take the message after Israel was set aside in Acts, because their government rejected Christ as the king. God raised up a new apostle. But my main point is in Galatians, he made it clear if a religion teaches that it came from new revelation from an angel, like Mormonism and Islam, and there's a few others, according to what Paul said 500 years before Islam started, that it's not true.
So maybe, Stephen, I don't mean to cut you off, but we're running out of time. Maybe you can call next week. But again, Paul came and then somebody else came after him. So maybe there is a variety in the messages and the delivery. I want to thank everybody who was calling, and especially our friends who keep calling and imitating themselves all the time. Thank you, Ali. NPR News is next.